Hi, I'm Ryan.
And I'm Romy, and along with our three kids, we farm here. We're Circle R Livestock. We are a sheep and layer breeder chicken operation.
We're just outside of Wallenstein, Ontario. We have 100 acres on our farm here, and we rent an additional 50 more. And we produce all the feed for our sheep here. So we started here in about 2005. I graduated college and I came to the farm here to work with my grandfather. There's a spot upstairs in the bank barn that wasn't being utilized, so I decided to buy 25 head of sheep. And that 25 then turned into 50, then turned into 75, 100, and then it just never stopped from there.
The joke was always, yeah, we'll have 1,000 ewes one day.
Yeah.
We're getting close.
Pretty close to that. Over the next following years, we slowly expanded up until 2018. We're both fairly busy full-time here on the farm.
So we're doing what's called an accelerated system. We have a continuous cycle of ewes going through. So each ewe will lamb about 3 times in 2 years. So there's always a group with baby lambs. There's always a group breeding. There's a dry group and also a pregnant group. So each of those four groups kind of moves through. And then we also add in replacements a number of times of the year. So for breeding stock, we're probably selling about 50% of the lambs that we're producing. If we're not keeping ewe lambs as replacements for the farm here, we're able to sell most of those to other producers. And then we also sell quite a few breeding rams. So that's been a really good way to diversify the income on the farm other than just selling market lambs. And then if they don't go as replacements or as breeding stock for other farmers, we're selling them to direct to the processor or to the livestock auction. We get asked a lot, you know, the buzzwords, do we feed organic, do we feed non-GMO and stuff like that. And in the end, I don't think it matters a whole lot to consumers. They just want to hear the story. They want to know what we're doing and how we're doing it. And as long as they know and we're open about that, it really doesn't matter how you do it. It's just they want to know that you care. And another one would be people think sheep need to be out on pasture. So our sheep never see pasture. I explain why they're in the barn. It offers protection from predators as well as intestinal parasites. And it allows us to manage them a bit different because we've got those four different groups always producing. So in the winter, we need a barn if we have baby lambs. In the summer right now, it's nice that we have the shade and the insulated ceiling from the barn here to keep them nice and cool. So again, same thing as with consumers asking what the sheep are eating. All consumers want to know is what you're doing and why, and they love learning about the different ways you can do it too.
This group here, these are replacement ewe lambs, so they'll have a different ration versus dry ewe. So right now it's corn silage, haylage, dry corn or cob meal, soy meal, and minerals. So all of our feeds get tested by a nutritionist. They're balanced for the groups. So our ewe lambs have a lot less energy in their feed because we don't want them growing fat. We want them to grow out their frame and make a nice ewe. Once we get over on this side, for example, with the ewes and lambs, we want her to produce a lot of milk for those lambs to get them growing fast. These lambs here, the oldest ones are about a month old. So this ration would contain a lot more dry corns, a lot more concentrates to not only help her maintain body condition, but also produce milk for those lambs. Our nutritionist that we have working for us, she pays very good attention to the feeds that we have available on the farm and balancing those for the different production cycles of the sheep that we have. When we do the breeding, we will divide. We've got a bunch of ram families that we have here, and we'll split them up into different pens when we breed them. Some of the ewes might get a more of a terminal ram just to produce market lambs, or if we want to keep a line going of female replacements, we'll put a certain rams with those females as well. And even with our out-of-season program, we're still very happy with results of our preg rate.
So on average with the mature ewes, it's been about 75-80% year round.
And once we hit into November, December, the real in season, you know, 95% is fairly attainable with the accelerated lambing.
Sheep and lamb in Ontario, we supply a lot of smaller processors, so we're not dependent on one or two large processors. So our lamb kept moving. We've still had the demand for our lamb. I was a little worried that with COVID sort of canceling family functions and gatherings that lamb demand might go down a bit, but it kind of seemed like that didn't matter. I've also been doing some value added stuff with some of our wool, getting yarn spun and selling some different wool products. Unfortunately, it's also something that COVID has affected because it canceled all the yarn and fiber festivals I was signed up to do this year. So I'm just sort of targeting more online sales, and I'll actually be launching some new products this fall. With sheep, I think we can be really sustainable. Sheep are an amazingly productive animal, so you can get a lot out of them for what you put into them. They're really efficient. I'm always amazed when we're lambing, the amount of amount of lamb they can produce from being a fairly small animal, and then they grow really fast as well. So there's lots of efficiencies as far as feed gains and things like that. And probably the entire sheep industry as a whole, we can do anything from like here where we're housing them indoors. There's producers who have sheep in a situation where they don't even have a barn, or they're doing silvopasture, or they're grazing under solar panels, or they're milking them. There's so many ways you can do it, and I think for an industry that's really sustainable too, that we have so many options.